is pretty underwhelming.
I call Brett Hudson.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise in support of the Energy Innovation, Electric Vehicles and Other Matters Amendment Bill in the second reading. It was a very good bill, actually, to sit on the Select Committee for. And I think we're all on both sides of the House looking for good means to provide incentives for people to increase uptake of electric vehicles. And in particular, actually, if you look at the way, because the measures were first proposed, obviously, by government and agreed to with some discussion by the committee. If you look what we're doing, the modern economics parlance, they call it behavioural economics. Of course, one of the most egregious tautologies ever disgrace the English language. But setting that aside for a moment, it's based on this idea of nudges, gentle ways of steering people into decisions that are good for them and good for our society. And this legislation or proposed change is an example, I think, Mr. Speaker, of nudging at its best, where we're offering some small but tangible incentives where people might decide that buying an electric vehicle is obviously not only good for the environment through a reduction in emissions, is good and sensible in New Zealand because the very next watt of power we generate is going to be renewable energy, unlike perhaps in the United States where their electric vehicles are actually coal-powered. In New Zealand, it is most likely that the next watt generated will be renewable. Therefore, you are in fact reducing emissions not only in the vehicle propulsion system, but also the electricity that it takes to charge it. That this just provides some small incentives that give people further reasons to move in that direction. So the idea of using a special vehicle lane, or at least giving councils the ability to permit electric cars, electric vehicles on special vehicle lanes, is just a small but meaningful way that might help people to say, I'll make this investment instead of another form of a fossil fuel power vehicle. I think we had some really good discussions about if we were going to do something as simple as allow the use of permit the potential use of these lanes, how could we be sure that only the right vehicles were using them? And ultimately, you know, the future is technology-based, and ultimately we have suggested that permitting the use of technology to monitor that compliance is the way to go, that stickers or even coloured number plates might have given a visual reference, but that in some respects is possibly the way of the past, not the way of the future. So I think we have returned a very positive bill to the House. I think the other little nudge aspect which I quite like is the exemption from road user charges for these vehicles, both passenger vehicles, which we did some time ago, but also heavy electric vehicles, is just, again, another small but tangible incentive that might help people to make a decision now to move to a vehicle propulsion system that's probably going to be our predominant propulsion system in just a few years' time. So, Mr. Speaker, I commend this bill to the House.
I call Gareth Hughes.
Speaker.